Where did everybody go? Oh, there you are. I'm sorry. I'm used to being up there facing this way, not down here facing this way. All right. Welcome to the Sherbino Theatre and our last performance of Nobody to Murder. Are you happy? I've been here 3 nights. We've had half this crowd pointing to the curtain, and both of those crowds were much louder than you. So, are we happy? Yeah! I like it. All right, I like it. All right, a few admin notes here. Welcome to our final performance of Nobody to Murder. This is our last production of the 2018 Sherbino Theatre series. Don't worry, we will be back right after the first of the year. We already have things planned. Are you ready for that? I hope so, because I'll be here. Anywho, we want to thank the Ridgeway Chautauqua Society and the Sherbino Theatre Board of Directors and the staff for having us in this beautiful house. And is this an awesome house or what? Look at this! What a huge improvement. Lost my place. All right. We have a few people backstage that we definitely like to point out some special attention. And don't let this worry you, but you're on a live show tonight. Woo! Back there on the camera with the little red light, that is Barthold. He's going to be running this and filming it tonight. So it's very important that you make lots and lots of noise and get all of our actors pumped up. And besides, I'm Hans, and I'm here to pump you up. Woo! Also, behind the house, we have Sandy, Annabelle, and Allison. They are working the box office and the bar. We want to invite you to the artist reception tomorrow evening, right next door at 6:10, featuring artist Tammy Brazee.
Yes.
Nice. Okay. And her, I got that right. And showing her exposing the sneaky marmot. We know that there's a few of those in this area, right? All right. Join us for the food and the drink and meeting of the artist. Oh. Alright, now for some very serious, serious business. Turn off anything that makes noise, such as cell phones, pagers if you still have those and you're living in the dinosaur age, you know, any Star Trek phasers or pagers or anything like that, bazookas, battleships, atomic bombs, turn those all off, please. Emergency exits, of course. In the event of a nuclear attack or Al-Qaeda coming in and like trying to take us hostage or something, our emergency exits are to the rear and out this door over here. If you cannot tie it in a knot and you have to go to the restroom before the show is over, please use that one right over there to the right. Your left. My right, your left. Left, right, left, right, left, right. Try to refrain from the ones back there, but you know, if you can't tie it in and out and there's somebody up there and, you know, like, stinking up the place, by all means, do what you gotta do. Okay, this performance runs just about an hour. There is no intermission. So there again, if you have to use the bathroom so bad you can't hold it, over there. All right, now, super extra, extra serious. Murder, as I know, because I've been caught for over 22 years. It's very serious business. So there's no laughing, no having fun, and you just have to remain quiet.
No.
We're leaving.
Alright, if you're going to do that, get the hell out now. Alright, guys, this is our third performance. The crew has worked very, very hard. This crowd is twice the size as the last two nights. And if you can't blow the last two nights away, you're pathetic. Let me hear it. Are you ready? I can't hear you. Are you ready?
believe that Garth shredded this week's reservations to make mulch. Who does that?
Well, he's the gardener, Mrs. Gattiger. We're lucky he'll answer that bloody phone at all.
Garth.
Garth.
Oh, look! He did make one reservation for next week. The annual Elvis Impersonator Convention will be here again.
You remember?
At least he got that one right.
You remember last year's convention? One more version of Hunk a Hunk of Burning Love. I was ready to choke somebody.
Well, we do have a week to gird our loins, as it were. At least this week will be nice and quiet.
Mrs. McGuire!
It's McGarrigan. Oh, calm down.
What I just heard on the radio, I'm so scared.
Damn.
There's an escaped convict. Pat Menace.
What?
An escaped convict. Pat Menace and Menace. Is that just coincidental or what? Menace is a bad word. And you know, like Dennis the Menace. He was a troublemaker. And he was a boy, not a real boy. He was a boy in a cartoon.
Now, Nina, Nancy, calm down and spit it out. What did you hear?
There's an escaped convict named Menace. And he's heading our way, right where I'm standing. And he's dangerous. And he might be carrying a weapon.
No, my dear.
A weapon. Mrs. McGuire.
It's Gerriger, and calm yourself down.
A weapon. It could kill us all.
Just because he's headed to the island does not mean he'll be coming to the inn.
However, we are the most prominent building from the shore. It's a bit worrisome.
No. Calm down. Get yourself to work.
I'm here.
Guys, you scared us half to death. My goodness.
Sorry, I was pleading.
Pleading?
With an axe? Big weeds.
There you are, Garth. Where are the tomatoes?
In the garden.
I know the tomatoes are in the garden. I asked you to pick me some for lunch.
Say please.
Get out there and get me those tomatoes.
What's for lunch, Dot?
Stewed tomatoes.
Stewed tomatoes? Is that all?
Of course not. We're having tomatoes and lemonade.
McGee, the door, please.
Dot's closer.
I'll get it. Hello. Welcome to the Come On In of Nova Scotia.
Goodness gracious. Goodness gracious. Oh, hello.
Hello.
We're the doctors.
McCarran,
McCandlish,
and Catter.
Welcome. I'm Ms. McGettiger.
Nice to see you, Mrs. McGettiger.
We're surgeons, always under a lot of pressure. We're very stressed. Very stressed. Yes, people are always yelling things like, "You've cut off the wrong leg," stuff like that.
That's you, Dr. McQuack, not us.
We need a holiday.
I'd say so.
Badly. We've been working night and day for months on our experimental muscle-building serum injection.
Dr. Karen, remember, no shop talk.
Sorry.
Well, you mustn't worry. Here at the inn, we're dedicated to your health and relaxation. You won't be disturbed.
Okay.
Nina? Nancy?
Oh, yes, ma'am.
Help our guest with the luggage, please.
This way, please.
Oh, right this way.
Uh, After you. Oh, no, after you go.
The door, McGee!
My back hurts.
Oh, I'll get it.
Hello. Come on in.
Hello there. Let me take your bag, Mrs.
Countess de Mer.
Oh, yes. Countess, pardon me. How was the boat ride?
Oh, unpleasant. It was choppy, windy, wet. I hate the water. Why must you be surrounded by water? It's so unpleasant.
It's an island. Islands are surrounded by water. That's why they're called islands.
Captain Lemaire!
What in the world?
That is some annoying woman who spoke nothing except about her pecs. She fell out of the boat.
You pushed me out of the boat!
Oh. You spoke only about the benefits of exercise. I thought you wanted to swim.
Welcome, I'm Ms. McGinniger. You must be Billy Body of Body by Billy Health Clubs.
She pushed me out of the boat.
I'm sure it's just some misunderstanding, but we must get you dried off. McGee, can you help with the luggage, please?
Right this way, ma'am. Crikey, what's in here?
My weight!
So heavy.
Come on, lift! It's good for the abs. Bend those knees and lift! No pain, no gain! Come on! Yeah, you can do it!
Now, do you see why I threw her out the boat?
There are sharks in that water, you know.
So?
Nancy, can you help our guest here with the luggage? Nina, Nancy, whatever your name is here.
follow me. age before maids.
Excuse me?
No. She means guests before maids, don't you, Nancy?
Yes, ma'am.
Right this way, Countess.
Aged guests before maids.
It's rather worrisome, though.
But you know, Mr. Gallagher, I'm a bit worried about this.
Well, of course I am too, but we mustn't let it show. Put on a smile on your face and be happy. We'll smile. Right. Happy.
One, two, three, four.
McGee, the door, please.
Well, that's killing me.
I'll get it.
Colonel Muckle at your service. Member of the Marines, the few, and the proud. We do more by 6 a.m. than most people do all day long. Why, it appears I have misplaced Miss Hidman Brown and Miss Von Broom. Hut, two, three, four, ladies.
Oh, my gosh. Come on, Miss Von Broom. We've made it.
You ran up the hill with those backpacks? Why?
Oh, one must always keep ahead of the enemy.
The enemy? Are we at war? We're just a little island. Who would want to go to war against us?
No. We're not at war.
One must always presume one could be at war. Keeps one fit.
We got a live one here.
Oh, and alive we shall stay if we stay alert at all times. Look to the left. Look to the right.
I'm getting nauseous. All that running, looking to the left and looking to the right.
Oh, Miss McGinnity.
McGinnity.
We haven't introduced ourselves. I'm Miss Hibden Brown, and this is my associate, Miss Anna von Brun. We're senior counselors with
Outward Ho! Our motto, health through hiking,
calm through camping,
serenity through self-sufficiency.
Outward Ho!
Outward Ho! Here we go! Outward Ho!
Isn't that nice? As you might have heard, Miss McGinniger.
Oh, Miss McGinniger.
Would
you like to buy a box of vulgar weepits from Outward Ho? If we sell 200 more boxes, we get to go camping in Switzerland.
Do not go to Switzerland. They are totally unprepared for war.
The Swiss don't go to war. They're always neutral.
They're neutral because they're always unprepared.
They're neutral because that's their philosophy.
Now. You're on vacation. No talk of politics now.
Oh, but everything is politics.
Perhaps you'd like to go to your rooms and relax. McGee will help you with your luggage.
No, I won't. My back's still killing me.
Nancy. Nina. Whatever. Can you help the guests with their luggage, please?
This way. Oh, ever since Colonel Muckle is here, I feel so much better about Pat Menace, the escaped convict.
Escaped convict?
Yes, and he's armed and dangerous.
Armed and dangerous?
Yes, and probably heading our way.
Now, he won't be wanting to come here. He'll want to get away from people, won't he? Take the guests to their room and not another word about it.
Yes, ma'am.
Right this way.
Outward Ho! Outward Ho! Here we go! Outward Ho!
Let's see, who else should be arriving? We have a couple more. Maybe we should look to see. McGee?
My back starts.
You're the butler. It's your job to check on the guests.
I may be the butler.
Get the door.
I'm not answering that door. You're the chef, and you've never made anything good to eat around here either.
Get the darn door, McGee.
I'll get
My
it.
My back starts. Killing me.
I have been knocking this spot forever out there! Hello, it's ever so wonderful to be here. The boat ride was fabulous. I just love the wind in my hair. My hairdresser is going to look at me on some amazing tips on my hair.
Very lovely. Lovely.
Thank you. Yes. Now, this is a very famous but retired actress, Greta.
I came here to be alone. I am exhausted.
And this is my brother, Bernard. As you can probably tell, he's a mime.
Mimes are not supposed to talk. They speak only with the eloquence of their bodies.
He's a very bad mime, isn't he, darling?
Just because I talk doesn't make me a bad mime. It's a whole new concept. You don't understand.
I think you've overdone your makeup a bit. You look very pale.
It's whiteface. Mimes are always in whiteface.
And really, that eyeliner, it's so passé. The natural look is in, you know.
No one understands a true artist in his lifetime.
Isn't he precious? Well, let's get the stuff out of here so we can eat.
Right this way, please.
A mime!
No one understands me.
I thought mimes weren't supposed to talk.
He's a very bad mime.
This reminds me of a movie in which I starred. It was called The Mime Always Rings Twice. It was a retelling of the Hunchback of Notre Dame story. I played a woman who was to be married at 1 o'clock. But the bell tower mime, being stupid, always rang twice. So it was always 2 o'clock. It was a love story with pathos and tragedy.
Let's get to the room. What do you say?
Not this way.
This week is going to be ridiculous.
See my glasses.
And pulse.
Oh, aerobics. I love aerobics.
And grapevine to the left. And grapevine to the right.
Miss Body, if we could just have a moment, sit down and talk.
Hey, Billy, do you think we could maybe talk?
And step. Come on. Feel the burn. Yeah.
Hey, Billy. If we could just take a little break and talk, just a little
bit. And reverse those shoulders! You can do it! And hips, back, right, front, left, back, right, front, and come on, Mr. McCandlish! Only six more to go!
The radio!
Oh, the radio! It could be a bomb! Everybody step back! Billy, I'll save you. Lie on the ground, and I'll protect you with my own body.
Get your hands off me, Colonel.
But I just thought I might be able
Sit
to...
Sit down, you old blowhard. Now, obviously, the problem is not the radio. The problem is what was heard on radio.
Oh.
I heard.
Calm down and spit it out.
There's going to be severe thunderstorms tonight and all evening long.
What is fun annoying me?
Stop it, Bernard.
First an escaped convict and now severe thunderstorms. They said, find shelter immediately.
Oh,
Nancy, this is our shelter. Again, we are in the shelter.
Don't panic. No one is to worry.
Yes, stay calm. Miss Van Brunen and I have had severe weather training with
our home.
What do you do to stay safe in a thunderstorm?
Well, you stay inside and hope it rains somewhere else.
Anybody, let's sing Kumbaya.
Kumbaya, kumbaya.
Anybody? Anyone?
No!
Excuse me. I don't know who does your hair, but nobody does braids or buns anymore.
I do buns! Come on, everyone! It's time for some aerobics!
And squeeze, release,
squeeze, release, and work those glutes! Yeah!
What are glutes?
What you sit on!
And squeeze, release, up, down.
Hey, Bill, you want to give me a private lesson?
No, I don't do private lessons.
And squeeze. Great job! In back to
inside the air around him.
Oh, this is such a bad line. That is cute.
Let me out of here. I'm running out of air.
Oh, ow. He's going to die in there. Somebody help him. Somebody. I'm a muckle.
What am I supposed to do?
The door. Open the door. Hit the doorknob. Doorknob. Thank you.
For God's sake, it's not even a real door.
Not Bernard's door, the front door.
Oh.
The door, please, McGee. My face hurts, and it's still the back.
Oh, I'll get it.
Inspector Black here. I had just come by to see if everyone was all right, and I found this man lurking in the bushes with an axe.
Oh, I was waiting.
With an escape convict on the loose. I find that very suspicious.
Inspector, this is Garth. He's our gardener.
For how long?
I'm Miss McGinniger, the innkeeper.
Ma'am.
Garth's been with us for, what, at least a year? He was here when the elves impersonators were here last year. Take these off.
Yes, it's all right. To tighten the noose on this convict, the authorities have stopped the ferry. The last boat is gone, so you're all stuck here until Menace is caught.
I have patience to see.
And there's no cell phone reception here. You know how many mind emails I'm going to be missing?
I just wanted to be alone.
Would anyone care for some homemade fresh lemonade or finger sandwiches?
No, the lemonade is terrible. The finger sandwiches really do look like fingers, but I don't want to eat one. I'm going to lose 5 pounds before I leave here.
Would you stop complaining? Do you know how many people would kill to lose 5 pounds?
Well, do you know how many people in this world would kill rather than listen to you?
You know what? I am tired of all of your complaining. I bet the homemade lemonade is absolutely delicious. McGee, I would like a glass of lemonade, please.
Yes, ma'am. But you're going to regret it.
Some air.
She doesn't look good.
Don't panic. Look to the left. Look to the right.
And don't drink the lemonade.
I'll try to get the authorities on the mainland. Maybe the Coast Guard can get her to a hospital. The phone. It's dead.
Oh, no. Billy, Bobby is dead.
No.
All right, stay calm. Stay calm.
The lemonade must be poisoned.
All right, that's it. I'm locking myself in my room.
Nobody leaves this room.
He's attempting to leave the room. I have a trained thespian eye. I know when someone is trying to leave a room.
This is now the scene of a murder.
No!
No one can leave.
I was just going out to water the garden.
But darling, it's pouring rain outside.
And Garth, you have neither galoshes or a Macintosh. You
catch your death of cold.
Getting wet has absolutely nothing to do with getting a cold.
It's a fallacy.
We're doctors. We know such things.
This reminds me of a film in which I starred. It was called Rain Person. It was a cross between Equus and Rain Man about a person who thought he was Flicka the horse.
Everyone, please, can I have your attention? We have a dead body here.
That's right.
I never liked her anyway.
What are we going to do?
We'll put the body in the window seat. Someone give me a hand.
Okay.
And nobody is to touch anything. No! I mean, after we put the body in the window seat.
Why did she say something?
Idiot. Careful.
Easy. She's dead weight.
But, Inspector, we really should examine the body of Miss Body.
Well, yes. Go ahead and examine the body. But don't disturb anything on it. I don't want any of the evidence tampered with.
Well, if we can't touch the body of Billy, how do we examine it, Inspector?
Especially now that it's in the window seat.
Well, just look at it, and don't go poking around.
What?
Oh, look! Bernard is miming something.
It seems to be a square dance of some sort.
No.
Are you stomping grapes?
No.
People! If I could have your attention, please!
Are you doing the chicken dance, Bernard?
No!
Are you playing charades? I love charades! I'm going to be on Mrs. McGuire's team!
It's Ms. McGinnigan, and we're not playing charades. There'll be no team.
He's miming a burial, and will be a terrible mime. He's also so inappropriate.
People! If I could have as much of your attention as you're capable of.
Inspector, we also, Miss Body, drink the lemonade, which now we know is obviously poison.
I warned everyone. Did they listen? No.
So, you had some, and yet you're still alive.
I spit it out, of course.
We've examined the body of Miss Body. There seems to have been a really sharp blow to the back of her head.
She obviously didn't look to the left and to the right and was caught totally unawares.
Colonel Muckle, she could have been looking to the left and to the right and still have gotten hit in the back of the head.
Yes, because we can't turn our heads all the way around, so we're just asking to get hit back there. What was the good Lord thinking, giving us heads that don't swivel?
There's more, like a knife slash. But I can't tell how deep it is, Inspector, without probing the body.
The gardener has an axe. An axe that can deliver a blow to the back of the head. An axe that can slash.
Guard! And there's blood on that axe!
Oh, no.
It was right there by the desk the whole time. Anybody could have just taken it in the dark and used it.
That's right. That's very true. And you've been fighting with Billy Body since you got here, Countess Demare.
Yes,
and she threw her in the sea with the sharks.
But I did not kill her.
Could it be my turn now, please? I am, after all, the inspector. We have a murder. On top of that, we have an escaped convict who could be hiding outside, armed and dangerous at this very moment.
So the two crimes could be related.
Oh. Yes. The escaped convict could be in this room right now. I have not seen any of these people before. Oh. Any one of them could be a convict.
And it could be a man masquerading as a woman.
So, it could be anyone. Outside, here, right now, in this room. But what about motive, Inspector? One must have motive to commit murder.
Well, I think that it's...
What about Colonel Muckle?
Me? What about me?
You could have a motive. This fell out of his luggage. And with all the excitement and bad news on the radio, I forgot to give it back.
Mm-hmm. Look, Inspector. It's a ring. Yep, there's a note. It says here, Dear Colonel Muckle, I've decided to marry somebody else. Here's your ring back. Warmest regards, Billy Body.
Don't!
Perhaps a revenge killing.
Hey, Colonel Muckle!
Inspector, there's a P.S. here. It says, P.S. I love somebody named... Bernard!
What? Bernard broke up with her! Didn't you? Bernard! Talk to me, Bernard! It's too late to start acting like a real man now!
I loved her! Why else would I have been doing aerobics? Oh, I hate aerobics! But I came back here to win it back from you, and I would have, you ridiculous mime! But now it's too late. Oh, damn you, Bernard!
Damn you, Bernard!
I'm innocent.
Bad mime or not, Bernard was supporting you, wasn't he, Cecily?
That has nothing to do with anything.
You have a motive. Where would you be if Bernard got married?
Cecily!
Sure, love a person never kill anybody.
So it was just coincidence that you were here at the same time as Billy Body?
Or did you come here to kill her?
Oh. It was Bernard's idea to come here. You didn't break up with her, did you? You were here to meet with her.
May I continue my investigation? Please. Now, where did the Countess go?
There she is.
You know, Inspector, I find her quite odd. Perhaps she could be Pat Menace.
You are just trying to divert suspicion from you.
Suspicion? I didn't even know the woman.
Unless you were trying to get on the health club craze and you needed to knock off the competition.
This is a murder!
It's McGallagher! Oh. Look, just because I wanted to open a health club here at the inn, and we wanted to offer Boba by Bendy health drinks, they were named after Bendy, our yoga instructor.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. And Billy Body's marketing department heard about it and said it sounded too much like Body by Billy. There's no reason for me to kill her. I could have just changed the name.
But you did not.
Looks like most of you have motive. And I suspect there are others who are still keeping secrets also.
Yes. Yee. Tall Billy. She would regret drinking that lemonade. Why did he say that?
Becker, let me explain. I've had some of that lemonade. It's awful. There's no sugar in it. It'll pucker up your face for a week.
This is getting us nowhere.
Well, I'm having the worst vacation ever.
Going to bed.
Oh, Cecily, you're right. He's a terrible mime.
Inspector, Bernard is right. The guests need to get some rest.
Well, all right. We'll begin again in the morning.
Oh, I'm not going to my room alone. I think we should all just sleep here and keep an eye on the murderer.
Whoever he or she might be. So we might be sleeping right next door to a murderer?
Someone should keep watch. That's what we do when we go camping with Albert Howe.
And if the murderer's on watch, he can just kill us all.
Oh! Hey, don't panic. I'll keep watch. Mrs. McFlurry, please turn off the lights. Everyone, get some sleep.
It's McGanniger.
And don't forget to look to the left and to the right.
Knock it off, Colonel Muckle!
All right.
Oh, let's sing Kumbaya.
And I found some very interesting things. Please, gather around. Yeah. What?
My candlestick! What in the world?
Oh! I'd do it.
That's my syringe. I'll need that. My knife for surgery, my surgical knife.
My pistol, for my own personal protection, of course.
Oh, look, it's my Businesswoman of the Year award. I love that award.
Well, is that it?
My butcher knife! I can't stew tomatoes without that.
Goodness.
My letter opener. I'm gonna need that for my social security check.
My Howard Ho pocket knife! I have really big pockets.
My
outward ho climbing rope.
My pruning shears for trimming my nose hairs.
Oh, God.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Hey, Black, that's my wallet!
That's right. All possible murder weapons.
No.
Now, everyone, I have to get these things as soon as possible to the police station.
Take
a look at
take
them.
It every
yes,
no.
McGee, the door, please.
I don't think that's coming from the door.
Would you stop making excuses and get the door for once?
All right.
What?
What?
Ah! Oh, that's what
it is! Billy's alive!
I told you it wasn't the door.
We thought you were dead!
Or the greatest mime I've ever seen.
That's not the inspector. He's Pat Minnis. Get him!
No, I'm not getting away.
Oh, no, you don't. You insidious fiends, never mess with senior counselors of Outward Ho.
And I'm not Billy Body. I'm the real inspector. And I have a terrible headache.
But how can we be sure you're the real inspector?
Because I'm the one with handcuffs.
But he acted just like a real inspector. A fine acting job, Mr. Menace.
I agree. That was a very good interrogation.
Well, all I had to do was ask myself a few questions, point my finger, and everybody was confessing to everything. Whoa. Hey, how you doing?
I'm still not sure you're the real inspector.
Let me explain. I work on the mainland, but was on the island yesterday because of the escaped convict. Billy Body called the station because she couldn't get through here. Because of the weather, she wanted to cancel her stay. So I saw this as the perfect opportunity to go undercover as Billy Body and find the escaped convict. When the fake inspector showed up, I knew he had to be Pat Minnis. But before I could arrest him, someone tried to kill me and stuck me in the window seat.
Me.
Just want to tell you one thing. If I had known you were inspector, I would not have tipped you into the sea. I am a law-abiding person almost all the time.
The real attempted murder happened when the lights went out after I drank the lemonade. And by the way, I really was choking on the lemonade. Put some sugar in that stuff, Doc. It's disgusting.
Okay. So I'm a bad cook. That doesn't make me a murderer.
No, it doesn't. So I was choking on your lemonade, the lights went out, and I felt something sharp. Lucky for me, I had on my bulletproof vest disguised as a warm-up jacket, so it was only a surface wound. But then, I felt a blow to the back of the head and was knocked unconscious. The next thing I knew, I woke up in the window seat, and I decided to pretend I was still dead, so you would all think I was still dead.
Mm-hmm. But why, when you already knew the fake inspector was Pat Minnis?
You're right, but I didn't know who tried to kill me. I figured the real attempted murderer was check on me in the middle of the night to make sure I was dead, And I was right. Lucky for me, the murderer didn't know a dead body from a live one. Dr. McCandless, I place you under arrest for attempted murder.
No!
Look, Graham!
What?
Wait!
Oh, no!
Wait, man, are
you? Dr. McCandless!
How?
You hypocritical oaf!
How could you? I saw you.
That'll teach you to try and attempt murder when senior counselors of Albert Hauer in the room.
Make them unhandy. Make them unhandy.
No
Why?
Way.
Why?
Yes, why? Why would you want to kill the beautiful Billy body?
I saw you drop into her at morning tea this morning, and then during aerobics, I knew you wanted her to get in on the serum deal, and I'd be out. You didn't want to be a business partner with me because I make one small mistake. I cut off one wrong leg, and nobody trusts me anymore.
That's ridiculous. Dr. Karen and I have completely trusted you for years.
Well, not anymore. You're an attempted murderer.
And sure, we were talking to Billy Body. Well, at least who we thought was Billy Body, and by the way, Mamma Mia, what a body, huh? Anyway, well, all we were doing was talking to her about making that investment in her gym. And we didn't include you because you lost most of your savings in that malpractice suit. Mm.
Yeah, but I knew she wanted it on the serum. And I knew I had to get rid of her. When the lights went out, I had my chance.
Wait a minute. How come Colonel Muckle didn't know that the inspector wasn't the real Billy Body?
Yeah. Well, Doc, you see, I'm blind as a bat without my glasses, which I did not wear on my one and only date with Miss Body. That's why I'm always looking to the left, looking to the right. I have no peripheral vision whatsoever. But like me, without my glasses, love is blind. And I fell in love and proposed, and when she refused me, I followed her here to hope to win her back. But now, don't you remember, I had misplaced my glasses yet again when I saw her at aerobics.
Oh, Bernard, what about you? Why did you not know this was not the real Billy Body?
So Billy and I have never actually met. We've just been talking online for months. Wouldn't even send me a picture. Was wondering why she was being so cold.
And so, the real Billy Body does not know your meme?
No. Told her I was an architect. Sent her a picture of my cousin. Male model.
What a loser!
That explains a lot now.
Romantic trysts, meetings, broken engagements. Obviously, Billy Body was a very busy woman. Now that makes a fine vocal warm-up. Billy Body was a very busy woman. Billy Body was a very busy woman.
Billy Body was a very busy woman.
All right! Many people had motive to murder. But only Dr. McCandless checked on me to make sure I was dead. That's how I know he's the attempted murderer. Luckily for me, he's not a very good doctor either.
Not a very good aspirator.
Oh, my goodness. Nothing like this has ever happened before at the Inn of Nova Scotia.
Yes. Usually it's quite boring around here.
Come on, boys. Off to the police station.
Wait a minute. I'll get the door. Excellent.
Can we leave the room now? I want to be alone.
Well, of course, I assume so. Right this way.
I'm going to make breakfast now if everybody wants to get cleaned up.
I'm starving. Is the food okay to eat?
Breakfast.
Garth, go and get me some tomatoes.
Say, please.
Please go and get me some tomatoes.
Say, please.
I just did.
Doc, you've got to say it twice. Please, please.
Oh, for crying out loud. Please, please go get me some tomatoes, you ridiculous numbskull.
All right. You just had to say it nice.
Well, looks like things are back to normal around here now. A little peace and quiet. Oh my!
Who could that be?
Garth did make the reservations for the Elvis impersonators for next week, didn't he?
Yes. Who is it?
The door?
I'll get it.
Lord Almighty, I feel my temperature rising, high and higher, it's blowing through to my soul. I'm just a hunk of burning love.
Wonderful.
I'm just a hunk of burning love.
Fantastic.
I'm just a hunk of burning love.
Here's your tomatoes.
Oh!
Tomatoes?
Yeah.